Okay, so we know that if you had two numbers, let's say 3 and 2, you could take those two numbers and you could add them together. So let's just focus on the 2 for a moment. I can take the 2 and I can add it to 3. What are some other fun things I can do with 2? I can take 7 and I can subtract 2 from 7. I can also take 2 and I can raise it to the fourth power. So these are all things that we can do with the number 2. Now, it just so happens to occur that in algebra, lots of times there are situations where you don't know the value of a number, but you would still like to perform or combine it with other numbers using operations. Like for example, I may not know the value of a number, or there might be a number whose value I don't know, but I may still want to add it to 3. So here's what we write in that situation: 3 plus the unknown number. And we're going to represent unknown number in algebra with letters. So I can take the unknown number and I can add it to 3. Why can I do that? Well, for the same reason that I can add 2 to 3. I can add 2 to 3 because 2 is a number, and likewise I can add x to 3 because x is really a number. It looks like a letter, but we're representing it as it really represents a number whose value we don't know. So likewise, I can take 2 away from 7, and so I can also take x away from 7. And then likewise, I can take, 2 and raise it to the fourth, so I can also take my unknown number x, whatever it is, and I can raise it to the fourth power. So these are examples of working with algebraic expressions involving what are called variables. So a variable is a number whose value you don't know. Now, it just so happens that sometimes you find yourself in situations that order of operations wouldn't let you get out of. Like for example, let's say you were asked to simplify, and you had this. You had 3 multiplied by x plus 2. Okay? Now everything looks fine in the sense that, x is a number, so it's an unknown number, but I can still add it to 2. And then once I do that, I can take that whole sum, and then I can multiply that by 3. So this is certainly defined if x is a number. Now the problem, of course, is that you don't know what the value of x is. So GEMDAS says, hey, do what's inside the parentheses first. So the grouping symbols. But how can I add x to 2 if I don't know what the value of x is? Okay, so it turns out that there's a property in algebra that we can use to simplify the situation. And here's what we're allowed to do. We can take this 3 and we can multiply it by the x and then multiply it by the 2. This property is called the distributive property. Let me show you how it works. 3 gets multiplied by x, and then 3 gets multiplied by 2. So this becomes, 3 times x is just 3x. We don't put the little dot there because there's no reason. There's no possibility of confusion. And then plus, now I should put the dot, right? Because if I just write this with just a 2, everybody's going to think I mean 32, but I don't mean that. I mean 3 multiplied by 2. And then, of course, 3 multiplied by 2 is 6. So I get 3x plus 6. So we have certain properties in algebra, and this property is called the distributive property. So there are certain properties in algebra that allow you to bypass the order of operations. So the distributive property. So this is one of those special properties. Let's see another one. So for example, let's say that we wanted to simplify. And we had 5 multiplied by 3x. Okay, so we're in a very similar situation as the previous example for the following reason. Well, I can see that these are parentheses, and I know with parentheses, You know, parentheses, in this case, they're acting as grouping symbols. So this is saying, hey, multiply the 3 by the x. The only problem is that I don't know what the x is, so how can I possibly multiply it by 3? And we have a special property that says that what you can do is you can simply drop the parentheses. Now you have to be really careful with this. You can only drop the parentheses when all you see is either multiplication or addition. So in this case, do you see how everything, all the only operation I see is multiplication? There's multiplication there, and there's multiplication here. In that case, we can drop the parentheses, and this is the same as 5 times 3x, and that's equal to, well, 5 times 3, multiplying from left to right, is 15x. Okay? Let's see that same property operate, or work rather, when we have addition. So for example, we can simplify. Let's go with 5 plus 2 plus x. Okay? So we're in the same bind because I don't know what the value of x is, so how can I possibly add it to 2 before adding that to 5? But as I mentioned in the previous problem, whenever it's all multiplication or all addition, you can simply drop the parentheses. In this case, when I do so, I get 5 plus 2 plus x, and now we can go forth because I can add the 5 and the 2 together to get 7 plus x, and that would be my answer. Okay, so when you use these two properties, that is when you drop parentheses in multiplication or addition, you're making use of what's called the associative property. Associative property. Okay, and there's one more property in algebra that we use very frequently. So we have the distributive property, we have the associative property. Let's see the final property that we're going to make use of. So we can illustrate that in the following example. Let's say you wanted to simplify, and you had, how about 5x multiplied by 2. Okay, so in this problem, you know, this is asking me, due to where the parentheses are, multiply the 5 and the x together, and then multiply that by 2. Now, we're in a similar situation, right? Because I don't know what x is, so I can't multiply it by 5 prior to multiplying that by 2. Now notice that if you simply drop the parentheses, that won't be enough because there's still going to be the x between the 5 and the 2. So we can use another property, and that property has to do with switching the order of these two factors. So you know, for example, that 3 times 7 is the same thing as 7 times 3. So when you switch the order in multiplication or addition, that's called the commutative property. So let's change the order here. Instead of 5x multiplied by 2, let me write that as 2 times 5x. That step right there is called the I'm making use of what's called the commutative property. So let's write that down first, just to celebrate what I just did. That was making use of the commutative property. Okay? And now what has that bought us? Well, now that we've done that, as we mentioned earlier, you can drop the parentheses. So this becomes 2 times 5x. Do you remember what that property was called? When you drop the parentheses, when it's all multiplication, that's called the associative property. So first I made use of the commutative property, and then I made use of the associative property. And then finally, 2 times 5 is 10 times x, and I get 10x. So these are ways in which the distributive property, the associative property, and the commutative property help us simplify algebraic expressions. And we'll be doing a lot of this in algebra, so make sure that you understand how we applied these.